Friday marks the anniversary of the first fissure erupting inside Leilani Estates. Tonight, we take a look at what life is like in an isolated community cut off by lava. Sarah Madison reports from the Big Island on Kilauea after the flow.
Here's what you don't see since the flow stopped. The other side of Highway 132. Now residents are asking for access on this highway, but as you can see, the challenge is daunting.
When that 6.9 earthquake happened and everything shook, we all knew something big was about to happen.
Nancy Seifer's home was surrounded by lava flows from fissures 17, 18, and 8, creating a massive kipuka, or land isolated by the eruption. Lava claimed one of her homes, but the fire took her citrus orchard. Like many others, she also lost power to her property, ultimately forcing Seifer's to go back to work.
Yeah, because I needed to get another place to live. For me, I can't at this age really come back in and live with no services. You know, all of my friends down below, they lost everything. They don't have a house to go back to.
To reach the homes that were spared, residents risked their safety and hiked across the treacherous lava field.
It was still very brittle and very porous, and there wasn't a path across yet. I'm 70 years old, and I wasn't the oldest one of us who would hike in. And it was beautiful and amazing, but it was hard. It was really hard.
These difficult and dangerous trips lasted months until April 1st, when Puna Geothermal Venture opened a vehicle access road on its property for residents only.
This is definitely only a temporary arrangement, access into the kipuka. This was the channel, right, from Fissure 8. And Fissure 8 was the one that flowed to the north. Each side is 60 feet, and in between the channel is, at least by our location, is about 300 yards wide.
This is where the lava river was gushing towards the ocean. Now it's an impressive lava canyon. Beneath our feet, you can see that it's still steaming, and yet this is the road residents use to get to their homes. This access was also made possible because of Lono Lyman, who owns more than 4,000 acres in the area. He's hoping more farmers will come back.
We have farmers that during the eruption were actually expanding their papaya fields on the edge of the lava flow. And we have others that are already back in and others that are looking to move back in to grow papaya, noni, and other crops.
Community members pooled together their own money to build and maintain the rest of the path. It's a long, hard trail, and this access is not the solution. The writing on the road says it all.
You're worried about if something happened to you, would the medical or the police be able to come in? So opening 132, I think is just it's the best answer for all of us. It is the only answer for us.
Hawaii County says it's hoping to make that happen soon.
We finally got the funding, the time period to, we just finished the survey for 132. That's our priority. We hope to finish that by October. We're moving as fast as we can. Naturally, I understand your impatience.
If we have a home to return to, and there are hundreds of us in here, then support us, help us get home. We always say the road to recovery is a road.
Reporting from the Big Island, Sarah Madison, KHON 2 News.
Tomorrow, Sarah visits with a displaced resident, finding hope in the rubble and rebuilding. Our look at the changes in Lower Puna over the past year continues all week right here on KHON 2.